labs that are sponsored by many multinational in India, such as Texas Instruments, which lead the way early in the 1987, Motorola, Oracle, or IBM also, you can remember.
Excuse me, ma'am. Your voice is not audible.
Voice is not audible. Okay, fine. So this is required for the educational institution must focus on research if they want to be on the top, as the MHRD and UGC have given a strict instruction to the university to strengthen the
research. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Hello, ma'am, am I audible to you?
I can give you some connection problem.
Ma'am, आप refresh कर लीजिए आपका session.
Please refresh your session.
Am I audible, ma'am? Hello?
Yes, ma'am, now it's audible.
Okay, though all we have already discussed about our patent projects and the research lab and the industrial laboratories that can help you. So it is required to the educational institution must focus on the research if they want to be on top. As the MHRD and the UGC have already given an instruction to the universities that work on how you can strengthen your research work. Or as I discussed, I want to share that IIM Ahmedabad has already taken an initiative in this line, in this field. They have designed and they have voted in a project where they have mentioned in their appraisal form that this will be research will be equivalent given weightage for they do research work. It will be equivalent to the teaching. So make sure you will be contributed on in the same manner. At the undergraduate level, itself research should be incorporated. The undergraduate student will start their research work from the second year itself, and there are so many universities and private colleges already start working on this. So it's my submission to you to please come forward for this, and the UGC student take up their research topic after much thought and that discussion, and some among them develop on the same topic of their post-graduation itself. And they can contribute to this topic to the PhD level as well. Now, after the brief description on the research and the project we are working, and I hope we all understand that if we are interested in research, then what should follow as well as to motivate us and our students to contribute something to the society and to our country India. Now, the next part will be covered by my colleague Chandra Mukherjee on the IP laws. And what are the topics? Thank you so much. If you have any query, you can please ask to me. Should we continue with the next session?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Once again, good morning to all of you. Thank you for listening us. After motivation and understanding what to do to become a researcher, we should have a clear knowledge about intellectual property. So I will start my discussion with the thing that is intellectual property. And we feel all of us understood what should be the developmental stage of our technical equipment. To become a good researcher, we should have a clear knowledge about how to protect our idea. There comes the role of intellectual property. Actually, intellectual property refers to any innovation. It can be literary, it can be artistic, it can be designed, as well as symbols, your names, images, anything that can be used in the commerce side. Now, this is the intellectual property law that is being designed by our government of India. It has been divided into three criteria. First one is trademark, second one is copyright, and third one is patent. When we are working for some idea, innovating idea, maybe we can get confused what to do with that idea. Whether we can file a patent on it, whether we should go for a copyright, or whether it should come under the trademark criteria. So that's why first I will discuss in brief what will be in trademark, what will be in copyright, and what will be in patent. So trademark basically is being used for the commercialized purpose, for the enterprises. If you are working for an enterprise, and then how will you segregate your product, that is different. Suppose you are making some soap. Several soap making companies are there, so how your soap is being different, that is being signified by the trademark. Next one comes for the copyright. Copyright is for your creative or innovative work. When we are going for some innovative or copyright, that can be copyrighted, like your computer program, your music, anything that is both creative and new, that can be copyrighted. And what about patent? Patent is being done on the hardware application, on hardware basis. When you are going for something hardware certificated, you are going for some project. Idea should be innovative in both case of copyright and patent. But copyright can be idea, but patent can't be idea. You can't patent your idea. It should be a fabrication. The all developmental stage, you should have clear in your mind what would be the developmental stage of your idea. Now at the next part, I will say it is the basic of stages of IP law. We have already talked about trademark, patent and copyright. Now what to do, how to do it, how to do patent, how to do copyright. So this follows these three basic steps actually. First one is your filing, second one is your examination, and third and final stage of your work is registration. So filing is that thing, it is very basic and very important thing, and it is the thing that will measure your product will be selected for patent, selected for copyright or not. And it is your own sole responsibility to file your patent properly. All information relating to this has been mentioned in our website, that is iitindia.com.in. So my suggestion will be, first go through the website properly, select your work, find your domain, which forms you have to fill, identify those things. After that, file your patent, because this can be the case of your rejection and selection of the patent domain. Now the next part, that is examination, it is not up to you. When you have taken the consideration of plagiarism, you have done the all formalities, then examination will be done by the patent office itself. Your idea will be published on the online. Everyone will be able to see whatever you have done. And if there will be some issues, like they feel they have done it previously before you, so they can raise issues, and that will be examined by your patent office, IP India, IP officers. And you will also get a chance to verify, to justify your answers. That is the part of your examination. And the last part, when examination is done, research, no such kind of refusal is there, that then you will go for the registration of your patent or copyright. Now, the next part of my slide will be the meaning of patent. Actually, I have discussed it in previous also. See, the patent is nothing but a right granted to the owner of an invention that prevents other from making, using, importing or selling the invention without his permission. The next thing, that is, it can also be a new method of doing things. What can be patented? The next thing of discussion should be, what can be patented? That can be a method of new method of doing things. It may be the composition of a new product or a technical improvement on how certain objects work. suppose take an example of IEEE paper, maybe in some idea you got from IEEE papers, but you have seen that way is not working properly, some limitations are there. You can resolve that, that limitation, you can suggest your idea, you can suggest your modification over that, and that can be put in. This is the main thing of the petition. After that, one thing I will ask from you, your side, do you have any idea what are the types of petition? What can be the types of petition? We have already discussed now what is the basic of petition. So from the basic concept, so what can be its type? How we can protect our idea? What will be the experimental result to protect our idea? Anyone from your side? My question is, what can be the types of patent? We have already discussed the basic concept of patent, na? And we have already told it is used to protect your innovative idea. So my question is, what can be the type of patent? How will be the type of protecting your idea? Suppose you are having an innovative idea, then how will you protect your idea? What will be the type of protecting your idea? Should I continue?
You can submit the only idea that we have patent, or we can submit the full after implementation, full documentation.
It's the process of patent, right? You are telling about the implementation, whatever. But I am asking you, when I am going for a patent, what to be patented? What will be the classification of patent? Okay, I am continuing with my discussion. So, patent can be of two types, that is utility patent and design patent. What is the difference between these two? That's why I was asking about the type for protection. Protective function of the idea. Whatever the function you give, utility patent protects that. And what is about design? Designing will be provided by the appearance. Appearance of your device, appearance of your whatever you have designed, that will be protected by the design. Okay. Now the next part, that is the benefits you can get from the patent. First one is, already it has been discussed, that is exclusive rights. Obviously, if you have filed a patent over it and it is granted, then exclusively that on that product, your rights will be there. Or whether you can use anything, whether you can share it with public, whatever you can use it in industries also, that will be your exclusive rights and your judgment to use your things. Now the next part, that is strong market position. Actually, in today's world, all of us maybe know some a part, that is impact factor of a person. If we search some name on Google, we found some name that comes on the top and some names are come on the downwards part. How it is been justified? That is been justified by the impact factor of a person. Impact factor of a person is being judged in 10 years before, we can say, by the number of publications. But as ma'am discussed the fact with you, publication is, good publications are there very easy, but publication is a issue that is also good for a research, but now it is being concentrated on the number of patents. Good companies, good person, if you want to increase your impact factor, you have to show if whatever what you have innovated. If you have innovated something, obviously you will patent it. So if you want to make your company at or your institution or yourself at a strong market position, then you should go for patent. The next part is higher returns on your investment. Obviously, this is your one-time investment after fabrication. At the time of fabrication, only you. After that, you can sell your product for commercialization purpose, and you can make money from it. If you are entrepreneur, if you are business-minded, then that is also being satisfied by the patent. Now, the next one, positive image of your enterprises. Already that thing, how many you have innovation done, that is being justified by the number of patents. So this is also very good benefit of the patent. Now this one is the procedure of patent. Two types of procedure you can follow. You can go for online purpose and you can go for offline purpose. But as we were the initiator, we have started it 2 months back, we went for the offline procedure because we felt we should take some advice from the experts before filing the patents. So that's why we went to the IP office in New Delhi, Dwarka. So this is the developmental stage or procedure for filing a patent. First one is search for the originality. Already databases have been shared with you from where you can search for the originality. Now the next part is download forms from the ipindia.gov.in. Already you have to fill up forms for your specification, for your claims, and as well as for your abstract and everything. And after that filing of your specification, you should request the IPO for a search and examination of your patent. That is also a separate form is there at their website. So please download and fill the form before you are filing. Now the next part, your application will be published online. That will be done by the IPO itself. After that, respond to comments from IPO. This is very important. After filing of the patent, don't think it is being done. We have filed, we have filed all the forms and all that, and our part is done. No, not that thing. You will provided by a login. Please check your application status frequently to find out the comments you are getting from the IPO. Because if you are not responding to the comments provided by them within 1 month, then your patent can be refused. So please be sincere. Check your application status. That is also being there. In their website of IPO. After that, after this examination, your form will be refused or granted, and after that, you can get benefit of your benefit from the patent. If examination form is not being submitted, if you are not submitting the examination form, form 18, then your patent will not be examined. So the next two steps will not be executed. And within 18 months, if you are not filing that form, then your documents, whatever you have submitted, that will be rejected originally. So please take this thing on your mind. Now this is the location of IDOs. If you are going for the offline purpose, then you can find IPOs in these four cities. It is in Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata and Mumbai. Okay. Now the next part of my discussion will be copyright. Already I have discussed the... Okay, copyright. Already we have discussed the theory of copyright, whatever. Now this is the types of copyright. Two types of copyright you can file. One is literary, another one is dramatic. Any work that is, I feel most of you are from engineering field. So you're
all from computer science.
Okay, they all are from computer science. Okay, then their work will be come under literary part of your copyright, because they are developing some software tool or they are working on some books. So it will come under literary part of the copyright. Now that this is the procedure of copyright, procedure of copyright is also almost same with the patent. Again, you have to, for this copyright, we have to go for the website copyright.gov.in, and the all relevant information which is required for your copyright that is being mentioned over here. You have to go. My suggestion will be for copyright, you should go for the online purpose, because for online purpose, you get the acknowledgement at the time itself when you are filing. So for further reference, you can use that number. If you are going for offline purpose, then what will happen? You will get the acknowledgement number after almost 1 month. So maybe you can go for the online purpose. After filling the form online, you have to post, you have to send that filled form with your acknowledgement form and the affidavit from the court to the copyright office, that is at Jeevandeep Building, New Delhi. After that, within 2 months, your copyright issues, whatever issues will be come, that will be encountered and your copyright will be submitted. Now, as ma'am discussed with you the patents which we have filed on that project, now I am going to share with you these two projects we have filed the copyright. First one is the automated and smart farming pot, and second one is the image processing executor. Okay, as for the patent, we have discussed the motivation, we have discussed the stages of filing of the patent through this experimental developmental cycle. I will also discuss the copyright with the help of this circuit only. First, will be the smart farming pot. What is smart farming? First, to understand my project, we have to first tell what is smart farming. Actually, our India is an agricultural based country and it ranks second worldwide in the farm output. But sometimes what happens, key farmers are not well trained in our country. So that sometimes because of their lack of knowledge in maintenance and nurturing, the plant, they face some difficulties. Some monetary loss is also there. To avoid this problem, to get rid of this issue, we have developed this thing. This is smart farming pot. This is the prototype of our circuit. We are planning to develop the UI in this manner. As you can see here, three types of sensors are there. If you go through a basic necessity of a plant, we are working on the sunflower plant for the first time for the experimental basis. We are now working on the sunflower plant. So two types of necessity will be there for the plant. One will be the water resource should be available properly to the plant, and another one is amount of light. Whatever the amount of light, we are working on the sunflower, as I have told you. So we will manage the water level by using simple water level sensor. It is very low cost sensor. You can see all of us, it's very common also. And that water level sensor will measure the level of water. Already we have done a classification on the sunflower plant. We have studied ki whatever the water intake it takes in the summer as well as in the winter. You know, na, water intake will be different in the summer and winter scenario. So we have done this thing. We have studied this on the net and some papers we have consulted for the study. After that, water level sensor will be designed in that manner. When the plant water level will be decreased, then what will happen? Then it will signal the motor. The motor will be on and that motor will provide the water to the plant. And also we have, if we are not concentrating whatever the level of the water or measurement of the output, that's why we have used a LED. If the level is being down or the level is being up of the threshold value, then what will happen? LED will glow, and after by showing the LED, we will understand the plant water level is not maintained. The same thing is the sunlight sensors, LDR, light dependent resistors, we will use for the sunlight measurement. If sunlight is not proper, then we have designed a slide cover that will be also regulated by a motor. If sunlight requirement will be there, then slide cover will be shifted, and if plant is almost in the sunlight, if sunlight is not required, then slide cover will cover the plant. Like this we have designed the UI, and this is the developmental stage of our automated and smart farming pot. Now the next project, that is image processing executor. Image processing executor is being developed on the MATLAB platform. Okay, when I was in my M.Tech, I was working on the signal processing and I felt some difficulties. When I was using in toolbox, when I was going with the MATLAB toolbox, I found that there is something is lagging. Some parts are lagging. That is, lagging part was that all tools were not integrated. Everything is there on MATLAB, but tools are not integrated. So for a initiator, for a startup purpose, it is not convenient, because when I have started working in the signal processing, I didn't know the all functions available in the signal processing. So if I don't know the function, then how will I use the help button in MATLAB? For searching something, I have to know na what are there. So from this thing, we should integrate whatever the thing we have in MATLAB. This is our GUI. Here we have segregated the signal processing in three parts. First one is compression, and for compression we have this algorithms are developed on the MATLAB. These four were the existing technologies in MATLAB that we have integrated on a single tool, and the last one was the new algorithm which was developed on the Wavelet platform. And the after compression, it is the next part will be your decompression. For the decompression also, we have integrated all the features that were separately available on the MATLAB. after that the conversion, if you are working on the signal processing, you know, first we have to convert the image, then we have to compress, and to retrieve the information, we have to decompress it. And for the conversion purpose also, we have integrated all the conversion tools that were available in MATLAB. And one more feature here we have added, that JPEG in MATLAB, you can convert JPEG image into that txt.txt format, but in our project we can convert GIF and PNG image also. This feature we have included in our project, and we are planning to submit this project to MATLAB for accumulation. This developmental stages are going on, we are working on it. So maybe our tool will be developed in the toolbox of the MATLAB. And this is the browse, convert, save image and close. So our UI is also very simple. We have used GUI based programming in MATLAB. For the browsing option, you can choose the original file. Then if you choose the convert option, then this provided option will be up to you, which one you want to use. You can go for the wavelet, you can go for CPG, PNG, whatever your choice is. Then you can save your image. After the converted image should be saved, that will be save image, and then our function will be done, so it will be closed. So quality value and compression parameters, that also you can control. Compression parameter, you can choose the compression parameter and quality value according to your field of application. So this is done from our side, and I feel we should go for proper research, we should go for proper innovation, because several opportunities are there. If you talk about how will I invest my time, I don't get proper time. But please concentrate on proper research, because to boost up your career, you can boost up your career by the original research only. These are the educational leading institute in India which can procure you, which can integrate, with which you can get integrated by your patent, by your number of copyrights, like IIT, IISc, NITs and state and central universities. And in industrial sector also, if we talk about, if we want to go for the industrial sector, then there also patent and copyrights matter. I want to share with you one fact. In India, last year Wipro filed 253 patents. So obviously if you are having patents, then you will get some weightage. And Google is the company which filed highest patent. That the last time Apple was there, Apple filed, actually I will share one more fact also. Over your first smartphone, 2.5 lakhs patents were filed. On a single smartphone, 2.5 patents were filed, and over 1700 patents were filed by the Apple on their iPhone. So these leading companies are also working on this patent and copyright. So if you, as I have discussed about your impact factor, if you want to increase your impact factor, if you want to become famous, then you have to follow this IP, intellectual property laws, like copyrights and patents. So this is the end of our discussion. So please, if you have any queries, then you can contact us by our mail ID, and that is neelam.ruhil@ggnindia.dronacharya.info or hodecs@ggnindia.dronacharya.info, and my email ID is chandra.mukherjee@ggnindia.dronacharya.info. So please feel free to ask yourself. And now, any question from your side?